Dear whomever it may concern, at the BBC, pass this letter to the Brains Trust very urgently. Throughout the war we soldiered on, when almost every hope had gone, and pinned our flagging faith to Verulam. We turned our railings into tanks and smiled politely at the Yanks when all they sent across was General Flynn. But when the lights came on, we found that victory was a sham. The lion's share turned out to be a smaller slice of Spam. The bluebirds came one dreary day, looked at Dover and flew away, and grim spectators murmured, "Why can't I?" They might go down to the sea in ships, but that's forbidden by Stafford Cripps, and the nightingale in Berkeley Square can only sit and cry. Could you please inform us who it was that won the war? The outcome isn't certain, heaven knows. Now everyone's so keen to put the Germans on their feet, for apparently the majority are really rather sweet. Meanwhile, back in Britain, we're still lining up in rows to buy enough to keep ourselves alive. So could you please inform us how we came to lose the war that we won in 1945? Land of Clement Attlee, where the teeth are free. Our former wealth is going to augment the inland revenue, and though our situation might seem hard, at least you needn't work these days. The Ministry of Labour pays you well, providing someone stamped your card. The national health is failing fast and no one gives a fig. The corpse will look delightful in a newly issued wig. Our image for posterity is one of grim austerity. The socialist nirvana's on the way. New ministries proliferate whose function is to allocate to everyone his fair and proper share of sweet F.A. Room 504 has met a somewhat grisly fate. Now everything's in duplicate. That 14th heaven and the old 10th floor is room 1008. So, could you please inform us how we came to lose the peace? Perhaps it's best to be the losing side. Now that the Americans are sponsoring the Japs, taking the view that but for a few they're awfully decent chaps. Such a strange development is wounding to our pride, the countrymen of Wellington and Clive. So Bevin only knows how Britain came to lose the peace when she won in 1945. 4, 3, 2, 1, yes, one. In 1945.
What? Shut! Basic training in jungle warfare by the right. Begin!
Come see the privates on parade. You'll say how proudly they're displayed. Of a military band, you'll be amazed how smartly we can take our stand. For when the bugles sound attack, 2, 3, 4, up goes the good old Union Jack. You may as well surrender when you hear our battle cry. There'll be no more escaping when we raise our weapons high. And in the victory cavalcade, you'll see the privates on parade.
Sergeant Barry, a word with you. Now, as you know, you're in line for another stripe. I've been watching you on the square. Well done. But leadership also calls for qualities of tact, diplomacy, understanding.
Oh, I never got after promotion, sir.
So let's suppose we're faced with a tricky situation here and now, shall we see how we cope? Here's this platoon of squaddies lined up, and you've got to announce some tragic news to just one man. Here he is in Singapore, and at home in England, his mother has suddenly, unexpectedly died. How'd you break it to him?
What's his name, sir?
Yeah, not important. Charlie Farnsworth. Come on, Bonnie, thinking on your feet and other of the qualities of leadership.
Private Farnsworth, one pace forward march. Right, son, pay attention. Your mother's dead.
Yep, hell's bells, man. You'll have him in the sick bay suffering from shock. Think of something more subtle, a roundabout approach, indirect.
Squad, squad, shun. All those men going to visit their mothers next time they're home on leave, one pace forward march. Where the fuck are you going, Farns Barnes?
Crusade!
Oh, thou to the little tiaras, ducky.
What?
The crown's on your sleeve.
Oh.
Rona suits you.
You'll need a piece of 4x2 to get a really good pull through. The enemy's resisting and the trumpet sounds advance. They'd best lay down their arms because they haven't got a chance. Faced with the cocksure cannonade.
More to your liking, Cartwright?
What, sir?
More like being a soldier.
Oh, doing a bit more jungle training, not so much bull.
All in good time.
We don't know, we're bulling the RAF.
Oh, yes, you are air crew, aren't you?
Navigating a bomb aimer.
Oh, yeah,
I joined underage to get a crack at Jerry. Soon as I passed out flight sergeant, ready to go on ops, all that off packs it in. Right, I thought to myself, see if we can't talk up a few nips. No sooner reached it on than Tojo says he don't want to play no more.
My story, too. All ready to invade Malaya, two big bangs all over. Belly solid, no fight now. All Lello men back to land of rising sun. And as for you, Major, we're giving you a new command. A unique operation. Covering the whole of Southeast Asia. Covering it with what, sir? Song and dance, Major.
I'll put in for my release. I said, you want to navigate a bomb aim to drive a lorry for 3 years? Jesus Christ almighty, a few weeks sooner I could have bombed Dresden.
A word to the wise, Flight Sergeant. Wise soldiers generally refrain from taking Jesus' name in vain. One day you'll need to call him in the clamor of a war. Then he would say, look here, you've often called on me before. I'm an extremely busy bloke. You shouldn't use my name in joke.
Such a sight.
To know that God is on our side makes every private swell with pride. We'll press upon our enemy until he's in a funk
and show him it's no easy thing resisting British spunk.
He'll feel the forceful fusillade of the privates on parade, on parade, parade.
The tour of Singapore is now over, and the time has come for us to go up country. Bring a bit of a song and dance to those chaps who suddenly find themselves chasing bandits in the Ulu. Ulu, that's the jungle.
But Major, I'm sure my contract stipulates that we're doing the number one tour and keeping to the main roads. There was nothing about the jungle.
No need for alarm, Mr. Dennis. But this country is a powder keg. Even the main roads are a death trap. Once we're on the mainland, we'll be in the front line. A theater of war.
You may as well surrender when you hear our battle cry. There'll be no more escaping when we raise our weapons high. And in the victory cavalcade, you'll see the privates on parade. Beside, you see. On the other hand, we're glad to see you come along tonight to drink. We've taken pains to see our shows us all that entertains. What can we do for the rest of the chorus? They know who we are, so they know. Entertains to see our shows us all that entertains. To see our shows us all that entertains. Entertains.
S-A-D-U-S-E-A.
Song and dance unit Southeast Asia.
Have you ever been down in Argentina? Have you ever known that special thrill? How would you like to mail a card from Venezuela? You could find romance in old Brazil. And in Valparaiso, girls would roll their eyes so that you could not tear yourself away. Come and have a gala down in Guatemala, the Latin American way. Come and spend a week down in Costa Rica. Come and lose your heart in Veracruz. Easy to catch a barracuda right by your hotel in Bermuda. That's the way we chase away the blues. Think how you could brag you are weekending in Nicaragua or wearing funny hats in Uruguay. Kill a nice vicuna underneath the moon, the Latin American way. Every senorita, welcome in the fleeta, and she pray her favorite saint to bless. Guys who rock the bota, they don't get my vota. I prefer American Express. Down in old Havana, life is all manana. No one work and everybody play. How could you resist a weekend with Batista, the Latin American way? Olé, the Latin American way.
Been far from sunny sideline. You've never heard us complain, but now that we're due in out of the rain, we never leave it again. And once we've left those cloudy skies, you'll hear us say, howdy guys. Once Mr. Blues is on the run, you'll hear us greeting Mr. Sun. Oh, we've been content, though we've never had a cent, because I've had you and you've had me. And every trouble and care seems so much less hard to bear, because we bore them in each other's company. Through all the storm clouds we've been true to one another, just we two. But now the rainbow's in the blue, the sun will soon be shining through. And though we've too often strayed from the bright side to the shade, together we shall never more run. From the heart of home, sweet home.
Dear everyone at 56, this is the last you'll hear before the boat. 5 weeks' time I'll be with you all, by which time my arm should be almost mended. Thanks for getting my old room ready, but can you fit in a double bed? Because my wife, Sylvia, will be coming with me. She's half Indian, half Welsh, and I'm quite sure you will make her feel at home, because she's so looking forward to meeting you, and her grandma, who lives in Swansea.
Don't forget to tell them I'm pregnant.
And here's another surprise. Within a few months, you'll be grandparents. Sorry not to have told you sooner, but with all that trouble in the jungle, it slipped my mind. So you see, Dad, the army has made a man of me, though rather late in the day. Don't write any more. See you soon.
Sylvia sends her love.
And so do I, Steve.
That homely little shack on the sunny side of any street. We've been too long from the laughter and the song that we'll share with all the folks we're going to meet. I know a lady living there, with shining eyes and silver hair. And when she offers me a chair, I'm gonna feel a millionaire. So though we've traveled around, now's the time to settle down. And when we're there, we'll never more roam. From the heart of home, sweet home.
Well, everyone, stand easy. We shall almost certainly meet again during the next 5 weeks at sea, but as fellow passengers, not comrades in arms. So I want to take this last opportunity of inviting you to drop in for tea if you find yourself in Berkshire. Nothing very remarkable, of course, only a simple 17th century mill house, typical of hundreds throughout the length and breadth of England. For every soldier dreams of the day when he can say, as we say now.
So though we